this tutorial, we'll look at the basic definition of a fallacy. Here's a very general definition of a fallacy. A fallacy is an argument of a type that is generally recognized to be bad. So, first and foremost, a fallacy is a bad argument. But not every bad argument should be labeled a fallacy. What makes it a fallacy is that the argument has certain general features that allow you to characterize it as a type, and it is these general features that are responsible for the argument being bad. This allows you to say that a given argument is bad because it's an example or instance of a particular kind of argument that is generally recognized to be bad. Here's an example we've seen already. If John exercises every day and watches what he eats, then he'll lose weight. John lost weight, so he must be exercising every day and watching what he eats. This argument is bad because the logic is weak. From the fact that John has lost weight, it doesn't follow that he's exercising every day and watching what he eats. He could be restricting his diet and not exercising at all. Or he could be exercising and not changing his diet. Or he could be sick and bedridden and he's lost weight for that reason, and so on. What makes this a fallacy is that we can recognize that this is an argument of a certain general type. It's an instance of the invalid conditional argument form known as affirming the consequent. For this reason, this is called the fallacy of affirming the consequent. This is an example of what is called a formal or structural fallacy, because the argument form is invalid. But not all fallacies are formal in this way. Here's an example. It's okay to lie on your taxes. Everyone does it. This is a bad argument, but it's not bad because of its structural form. It's bad because it relies on an assumed premise that most of us would reject. Here's how you might reconstruct this argument. The assumed premise is something like, if everyone does something, then it's okay to do it. When you reconstruct the argument in this way, the logic is perfectly fine. It's a valid argument. The problem is with that first general premise. Most people would reject the view that an action is morally all right as long as everyone does it. What if you lived in a slave culture and everyone practiced slavery? Would that make slavery morally okay? This is sometimes called the bandwagon fallacy, or the appeal to common practice, and it's an example of what is usually called a content fallacy. A content fallacy is a fallacy that relies on a false or dubious premise of a certain kind. Note that here the second premise is false too. Not everyone lies on their taxes. But simply having a false premise isn't enough to make an argument guilty of a content fallacy. It's a content fallacy only if the major premise that the argument is relying on is of a certain general type that would be judged as false or dubious in the particular case in question. In this case, it's the first premise, the general premise that relates common practice to moral acceptability, that is responsible for this being a fallacious argument. An important point to remember about fallacies is that you can't judge an argument based on its superficial form as given, since we often leave out parts and rely on our audience to fill in the gaps. So if I give an argument like this, whales can't breathe underwater, they're mammals. It would be unfair to say, for example, that it's bad because it's logically weak, since there's no stated connection between being a mammal and being able to breathe underwater. In other words, it would be unreasonable to evaluate the argument based on this interpretation and argue that the logic is weak. Why? Because it's obvious that the argument relies on an implicit premise. Mammals can't breathe underwater. Only after you add this premise can you then evaluate the argument. And in this case, the argument is good. Both premises are true and the argument is valid. So, let's summarize. 1. A fallacy is an argument of a type that is generally recognized to be bad. And 2. You should evaluate an argument only after the argument has been reconstructed to include any implicit or assumed premises. Very often, the fallacy only becomes obvious after you reconstructed the reasoning.